was a lot of controversy and debate as to the consequences of what he tweeted and then the fact that he apologized and retracted the said tweets. Now, others have tried to put this side by side and juxtapose it with comments with comments that were seen on your official Twitter handle in about July 2012. Regarding reprisal attacks if a Fulani life is taken. So there have been a lot of controversy and a lot of debate as to this governor has said this and then this governor has acted this way. For clarification's sake, where do you stand on the situation with Alvin Mekori and where do you stand on that tweet?
Okay, look, let me start with me. I have used social media as a citizen, as an opposition politician very effectively. I have over 1 million followers on Twitter. I have over 750,000 followers on Facebook. So I know the power of social media, and I have the capacity to counter any propaganda personally, because I have more following than any public officer, any public figure in Nigeria. But we must use that power with responsibility. People are making reference to what I tweeted in 2012. What did I tweet? I tweeted that any person, soldier or not, that kills a Fulani takes a debt that will be repayable in 100 years. It's a statement of fact. It is not a threat. It is not an incitement to violence, and there is a context to it. In 2012, the general officer commanding 3rd Division Nigerian Army in Jos gave an instruction at the behest of the governor of Plateau State to wipe out 2 Fulani settlements just outside Jos, on the suspicion that they have weapons. This was reported by the governor of Plateau State, and the commander gave the order, and I heard about it. I called and said, look, don't do that. Go and surround the place and search for weapons. But that was not the objective. The objective was to remove them from the settlement because they are settlers. And people that think that that land is their ancestral land want to take the land. It is not because they have weapons. Now, I know the nature of the nomadic Fulanis. My great-great-grandparents used to be such people. If you kill any of them unlawfully, they organize to take revenge no matter how long it takes. Now, for me, the danger is this. If the Nigerian army goes and wipes out a Fulani settlement, any person wearing a Nigerian army uniform in 14 West African countries is at risk, because these Fulanis may have relations in Mali, in Ghana, in Sierra Leone, in Guinea, and word will go around that the Nigerian army has committed genocide against the Fulanis, and anywhere you see a person wearing a Nigerian army uniform is a target for retaliation. And I warned the commander this would happen. He did not listen, and that's why I put it on the record. So that when it starts happening, nobody will say he was not warned. Ultimately, because of that tweet, the commander retracted his plan, and they went and surrounded the settlement and searched for weapons and found none. And to me, what I did averted a potential disaster, but that is being put as if I tweeted something inciting anyone. If you don't believe me, if you don't believe what I tweeted, go and do what I said, don't do it, and see the consequences, okay? But fast forward to 2016 or 17. What did Aldo Mekori do? Aldo Mekori rushed to publish a false story without checking with anyone. But before then, he had posted fake pictures of Boko Haram attacks, Rwandan genocide, as Southern Kaduna killings, and elicited a lot of emotion on social media. But more than that, what he posted may have led to killings, and we are trying to link the dates of the posting to attacks that may happen the next day on Fulanis. And if we're able to establish that causation, as lawyers, you know what it means. It is totally irresponsible to do that. And even when it was pointed out to him that, look, this information is untrue. The College of Education runs no mass communication program, and they issued a statement denying that anyone was killed because the school had been closed since November. So how could a school that had been closed have students that could be killed? He still posted that he stood by his story. He questioned the authenticity of the press statement. He was totally and completely irresponsible. And we are going to prosecute him. He was arrested. His statement has been taken. He's on bail. He's going to be prosecuted. His fate will be decided by a judge. It's not Nasir-El Rufai. It's not personal. I have nothing against him. In fact, he has worked with the state government in the past. But I'm not going to sit as governor of Kaduna State and allow anyone to post or tweet anything that leads to loss of lives without consequence. That would be irresponsible on my part. It is a matter of law. It is not a matter of emotions. And since we started going after people that have posted these fake pictures, we've had some sense of moderation in this. You cannot rush and use a platform like that without checking. Because there are two sides to this conflict. And anything you post can elicit a reaction from one of the sides. So you should at least be sure that what you're posting is true. And there are ways of checking. It takes 5-10 minutes to check. 5-10 minutes. Call the police. There are authorities that you can check this thing. But you are rushing to get retweets and following without regard to the fact that what you're doing could lead to more violence or loss of lives. I'm the governor of the state. I'm not in this game to get following. My responsibility as governor of the state is to ensure the security of lives and property of the state. And I will not allow anyone, even my own son, to do that kind of thing without consequence. There will be consequences, and I want to put it here that social media, like every technology, is value neutral. You can use it for good, or you can use it for evil. Now you have to make a choice to use it for good. In my opinion, after many years in public service of Nigeria, I've come to the conclusion that this country has three major challenges. And I think we should all work together to resolve them. The first is nation building. We are an artificial creation, yes. But we have the opportunity out of that artificial amalgamation to build a nation where there is economic progress, which is the second challenge, and equal opportunity for all. This cannot be achieved if technological tools are used to democratize hatred. And for those that are activists in social media, I warn you, you can use this tool to advance the causes of this country, or you can use it to divide the country and live with the consequences. And if you don't conduct yourself in a manner that is sensible, that advances nation building, economic progress, and equal opportunities for all, the social media will not remain ungoverned. You will be legislated against to govern how to operate in that space. It is my view that under the Penal Code of Kaduna State and the criminal code that is applicable in most of southern Nigeria, there is enough in those laws to prosecute those that abuse the privilege of social media.